Good morning to all. Today, let us see carbon nanotubes. In this lecture, we are going to see what are carbon nanotubes and the classification of carbon nanotubes, such as single wall carbon nanotube and multi wall carbon nanotube. Then, the structure of carbon nanotubes, like zigzag structure, armchair structure, and chiral structure of carbon nanotube. Then we are going to discuss about the NM notation and the chiral angle of carbon nanotube. And finally, we are going to discuss about the properties of carbon nanotubes, like mechanical properties, electrical properties, optical properties, and thermal properties of carbon nanotubes. First, let us see what are carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotubes are the tubes which is made up of carbon atoms. Its diameter is typically of the order of nanometers. Carbon nanotubes is a fullerene related structure which consists of graphene cylinders closed at either end with gaps containing a pentagonal ring. In carbon nanotubes, it is popularly abbreviated as CNT. So, which are formed by rolling up a graphene sheet into a cylinder and capping each end with half of the fullerene cylinder. The carbon nanotubes are extremely long, which is of the order of few hundred nanometer and more. Carbon nanotubes are discovered in the year 1911 by the Japanese electron microscopist Sumio Aijima. While he was studying the material which is deposited on the cathode during the process of arc evaporation synthesis of fullerene, he found that the central core of cathodic deposit contained a variety of closed graphitic structure, which including nanoparticles and nanotubes of a specific type. Then, the classification of carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotubes are classified into two types. One is single-walled carbon nanotubes and multi-walled carbon nanotubes. When you look at the cross-sectional view of the single-walled carbon nanotubes, you will see a ring-like structure. In multi-walled carbon nanotubes, it is further classified into two types. One is Russian dollar structure and another one is Boschman structure. In Russian dollar structure, it having many cylinders, concentric cylinders. Its cross-sectional view schematically look like this. In Boschman structure, a single sheet of graphene that is rolled to produce the multi-walled structure. Schematically, its cross-sectional view will be like this. In single-walled carbon nanotube, a single graphene sheet is rolled to make a carbon nanotube. Graphene is nothing but it is a allotrope of carbon atoms. It is a form of carbon, it is a different structural form of carbon atoms. In this form, a single layer of atoms in a two-dimensional hexagonal lattice in which one atom forms each vertex. So this shows the diagram of graphene. It is rolled to make a carbon nanotubes. So this is the carbon nanotube. In single walled carbon nanotubes, so a single graphene sheet that is rolled to make a carbon nanotube like this. Next, multi walled carbon nanotube. The multi walled carbon nanotube, which contains nanotube of one with a smaller radii that lies inside and the other of longer radii that lies outside and so on. So this figure illustrates the schematical representation of a multi-walled carbon nanotubes. Next, the classification of carbon nanotubes based on the structure and symmetry property. The carbon nanotubes are classified into three types, which is zigzag structure. In zigzag structure, armchair structure and chiral structure. In zigzag structure, this black arrow indicates the axis of the tube. in zigzag structure. The graphene sheet is rolled to make a cylinder. This black arrow indicates the axis of the tube. At the end portion of the cylinder, you will see this zigzag pattern. In other words, we used to say the CC bond is parallel to the axis of the cylinder. In armchair structure, this black arrow indicates the axis of the tube. So it is rolled to make a cylinder. This whose axis is this? When you look at the ends of the tube, you will see this armchair pattern. That is why this is called armchair type. In chiral structure, so this graphene sheet is oriented in such a way that the CC bond that is making an inclination angle between the axis of the tube. So these two have some symmetries or symmetry properties, but in chiral structure there is no symmetry. The structure of carbon nanotube. These structure of different carbon nanotubes which differ in their symmetry property. The carbon nanotubes can be thought of a graphene plane which is rolled up in a cylinder form. The closed end of carbon nanotubes depends on how the orientation of graphene plane is cuttered before rolled up. Based on these only the type zigzag, armchair and chiral type is exist. The zigzag and armchair have symmetry. These are called non-chiral structures. This figure shows the different type of carbon nanotubes. So when you look at this, you will see this zigzag pattern at the end of the carbon nanotubes. It is a zigzag type of carbon nanotube. When you look at this, you will see this according to the axis of the tube, you will see this armchair pattern. So which shows that this is the armchair type of carbon nanotube. When you look at this, the CC bond that is making inclination between the axis of the tube. So this structure is called the chiral type of nanotube. Then the NM notation and the chiral angle of carbon nanotube. The NM notation of a carbon nanotube is used to denote the structure of carbon nanotube. Since the carbon nanotube with many different radii can be formed, which is depending upon how the large is the graphene area that is folded into a particular cylinder. Since the carbon nanotube is the same type like single walled carbon nanotube with a different radii can be formed. So the NM notation is used to differentiate that type of carbon nanotubes. To describe the structure of carbon nanotubes, we should imagine the nanotube is sliced open by a cut that is parallel to the axis that goes through some atom and rolled and flat into the plane. To understand the NM notation, so look at this. This is a graphene so in this I am marking the atoms. This is the second nearest neighbor. So the marked atoms, this repeatedly forms the lattice of the carbon nanotubes. So I'm taking the origin 0,0 is here. The atom, any one lies along this. I'm taking this atom is folded in such a way that it is
coincide with the atom, with this the origin atom. So the vector connecting these two means this vector that is called chiral vector or circumferential vector. So to understand this, the basis vector of this basis vector in this direction I am taking, it is u, and the basis vector in this direction it is v. So this vector this vector is a circumferential vector. So c, this is chiral vector or circumferential vector, cnm, this should be written as n times u vector plus m times v vector. When we look at this vector, this 1u, 2u, 3u, 4u, so this point in u this is 4 units, in v this is 0 units. So this vector is represented as 4u vector plus 0 v vector. So this should be represented as 4 0. When I fold this paper, imagine this is a graphene sheet, it is by folding it is making a carbon nanotube. Just so to fold this, I'm just so this is the carbon nanotube. By imagination, this is the carbon nanotube. When you look at the end of the tube, you will see the zigzag pattern. So in zigzag pattern, any one of n comma m should be zero. So n, any one of n comma m, n, any one of n comma m is zero, which means either 0 comma n or n comma 0 type, this structure should be a zigzag type of carbon nanotube. Zigzag type of carbon nanotube. To understand the armchair type of carbon nanotube, so in armchair type, look at this. So the edge of the carbon nanotube should be in armchair pattern. So this is obtained by folding this graphene sheet to coincide this atom with this atom. For example, it is coincide like this. So when you look at this, you will see the armchair like pattern. So to find out the to identify the its vector, circumferential vector, this is its chiral vector or circumferential vector. So to find out the circumferential vector, this lattice vector is taken as u and this is taken as v. So length up to this is 1u plus 1v. By applying parallelogram law of vectors, this is 1u plus 1v, and this is 2u plus 2v, and this here it is 3u plus 3v. So this point is nothing but 3 comma 3, which means 3u vector plus 3v vector. So chiral vector of this circumferential, the circumferential vector is 3 comma 3. So the 3 comma 3 or n comma n, generally that denotes the armchair type pattern. But for chiral type pattern, anyone, I am noting this, I am taking this, I am connecting this with origin. Simply I am connecting this with origin. So this is, it is folding in such a way that this atom is coincide with this origin. It will give the chiral like structure. Okay, let's point the circumference vector. Let's find out. So after moving it from here, it is 1 unit. In u, it is moving 1 unit. After that, it is going here by, in u and v, it is 1 unit. But v, here after, it is going 3 units. So in u, it is moving only 1 unit, but in v, it is going 1, 2, 3, 4 units. So this is denoted by 1, 4. So this 1, 4 is a chiral vector, of a specific chiral nanotube. Next, chiral angle. To find the chiral angle, let us consider, this is basis vector u, this is basis vector v. Now I am taking a chiral structure by connecting this atom with the origin atom. So this I am taking an origin. So this atom, I am folding this graphene sheet to join this atom to this atom to make a carbon nanotube. So I am simply connecting these two. So the angle between its chiral vector or circumferential vector with its any one of basis vector is usually denoted as the chiral angle. So chiral angle is the angle between the chiral vector to the basis vector. When you look at the armchair structure, the chiral vector is this. It is making angle 30 degree with the basis vector. In chiral type structure, the chiral angle lies from 0 to 30 degree. When you look at the when you look at this type of zigzag structure, here the circumference vector that is parallel with the u vector. So here the chiral angle is 0. So the both the chiral angle and the MN notation is used to identify or represent a carbon nanotube.
Next, properties of carbon nanotubes. Mechanical properties. The carbon nanotubes are the strongest and the stiffest material, which in terms of its tensile strength and elastic modulus. A multi-walled carbon nanotube have a tensile strength of about 63 gigapascal. The individual carbon nanotube shell have strength up to nearly 100 gigapascal. though the individual C and T have high strength, which have weak shear interaction between adjacent shells and tubes, that lead to a significant reduction in the effective strength of multi-walled carbon nanotubes. The carbon nanotubes are not nearly as strong under the compression because of their hollow structure and high aspect ratio. They tend to undergo buckling when placed under compressive, torsional or bending stress along the axis of the tube. The carbon nanotubes are very soft in radial direction. Its Young's modulus of the order of several gigapascal showed that the carbon nanotubes are in fact very soft in their radial direction. Electrical properties of carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotubes are either metallic or semiconducting along their tubular axis. For a given NM nanotube, if N is equal to M, the nanotube is metallic in nature. Thus, all ultra type of nanotubes are metallic in nature. If modulus of N minus M is multiples of 3 and N is not equal to M and NM is not equal to 0, then the nanotube is quasi-metallic with a very small band gap. Carbon nanotubes of 6, 4, 9, 1, etc. are semiconducting in nature. The radial diameter of the carbon nanotube, which influences the electrical properties. Thus, a 50 single-walled carbon nanotube that should be semiconductor in fact, but according to the calculation, it is found that it is conductive in nature. Similarly, the zigzag and chiral single-walled carbon nanotubes with a small diameter that should be metallic have a finite band gap. The metallic carbon nanotubes can carry an electric current density of 4 into 10 power 9 ampere per centimeter square. Next, optical properties of carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotubes have useful absorption, photoluminescence and Raman spectroscopy properties. Semiconducting single-walled carbon nanotube that emits a light of near infrared region upon photo excitation. The photoluminescence means when light falls on, or electromagnetic radiation falls on the nanotube, it will emit the photons. The photoluminescence from single walled nanotube as well as optical absorption and Raman scattering is linearly polarized along the axis of the tube. So this allows the monitoring of the single walled nanotube structure, other electron microscopy studies. The interaction between nanotubes or between a nanotube and another material may quench or increase the photoluminescence property. No photoluminescence is observed in multi-walled carbon nanotube structures. Next is thermal properties. The carbon nanotubes are very good thermal conductors. It is having high thermal conductivity. Its thermal conductivity is 10 times longer than that of silver. The measurement shows a single-walled carbon nanotubes at room temperature, the thermal conductivity is about 3500 watt per meter per Kelvin in the tube axis direction. In single-walled carbon nanotube, the thermal conductivity in perpendicular to the tube direction is about 1.52 watt per meter per Kelvin. There is a large change in the axis direction and in the perpendicular to the tube axis direction. The thermal conductivity in carbon nanotube is mainly due to the phonons, which means vibrations, rather than free electrons. These are all the references. Thank you.